Tether off stride for the love of money. For the love of money off stride there. Umbral Affair guns up with Trevor Ritchie. From between horses, Don't Duddle. And from the inside comes Lexus Hall with early speed. Pizza Dolce left well. She's fourth on the outside, floating out there and looking for position around the first turn. Trevor Ritchie and Umbral Affair. Here comes Moisev with Don't Duddle up on the outside and filling the gap, leaving her out there. Lexus Hall third to the quarter. Pizza Dolce is fourth. Stroke play, the favorite is fifth past the opening quarter. Del Martha settles back into sixth. The gap at two lengths to Sunday Yankee. Seventh then comes Fast Lane K. Gap at two lengths to Philly at Biggs. Next to last after the break, far back for the love of money. She's back trotting 28-1. Not much pace here. It's Don't Duddle. 25-1 on the board here. Don't Duddle. And Trevor Ritchie squeezes out there with Armroll Fair, leaving Pizza Dolce three wide. So the Phillies mix it up the backstretch here. Lexus Hall off the cones from fourth. LeChance with a bid now. Gap at two lengths. Stroke play. Watching the action intently is fifth past the half mile. Then comes Del Martha sixth, followed by Sunday Yankee under urging, dropping back Fast Lane K on the inside, followed by Philly at Biggs, and far back after that break for the love of money. And here is Lexus Hall, a sweeping move. Lexus Hall to the top with LeChance, and that leaves stroke play uncovered, taking a shot first over off the half of 56-3. They're at three quarters. Lexus Hall here, 12-1, looks for the upset. Stroke play on the outside comes calling on her, and here comes Del Martha looming large for Campbell. Live cover for her. Pizza Dolce in the box. Sunday Yankee setting up a rally. 126-1. Head of the stretch now. Stroke play trying to grind it first over here to the top. Stroke play puts away Lexus Hall. All up now is Del Martha. Between horses, Armroll Fair looks for room. Pizza Dolce is empty. So is Sunday Yankee to the line. It's stroke play. Stroke play the play tonight. Brian Sayers, Todd Spencehammer get their first Breeders' Crown.
After overcoming post 14 in her elimination, this must have seemed like a trot in the park for the Yankee Glide filly. Winner of four in a row now, including the Matron Final. Winning trainer Tron Smedzammer earns his first crown win in five tries. A former protege of Per Henriksen. This has to be a sweet victory for Tron after his Power to Charm disappointed as the favorite in this year's Hamiltonian. And what a year for Brian Sayers, capping his best season ever with his first crown win in just his sixth drive. Last race two for the two-year-old divisional champ Pizza Dolce, scheduled to be bred to Kadabra next spring.
Armbrough Affair was disqualified from fourth for coming out late under Pizza Dolce on the backstretch, and Brian Sayers has joined an elite group of crown-winning drivers.
Well, it looked like Pizza Dolce wasn't herself tonight, and looked like I might be able to drop in the two-hole, but I was covered up pretty much most of the way, and I know the way my filly likes to finish, so I was pretty confident at that point.
She's had an adventurous year. She wasn't herself on Hambo Day in the Oaks, but she's really turned it on the last month or two.
Yeah, she has. She's been super last couple months. I just want to thank Tron for giving me the opportunity to drive her, and she's been a great horse for me to drive.
What's it like winning your first Breeders' Crown?
Oh, it's everything that I thought it'd be and more. I'm just really grateful for the opportunity, and it's great.
How'd you together with Tron?
Well, I've known him for some time because he's a Norwegian like I am, and he told me that he might be willing to sell a horse in Lexington, and I did that. I bought him.
Well, ever since she went to you, she's been tremendous. Certainly the best filly we've seen the last couple of months.
Well, she's been fantastic. I used to own half of Yankee Glide Desire, and that's why I like her. And I'm in the breeding business, so I went on it for it, and I'm very, very happy. I'm excited. I'm out of this world for me. And I've been in the business here for 25 years. I've been racing in the States for 30 years. I have a son who's the fifth generation in the family, who is also in the business. He drove his first race here in 1999. He won at Meadowlands, so I'm thrilled.